प्रबुद्ध भारत के इस द्वितीय सम्मेलन में उद्घाटन सत्र में मंचासीन तीनों विश्वविद्यालय के सम्माननीय कुलपति महोदय और प्रबुद्ध भारत के आयोजन के पीछे की शक्ति श्री चैतन्य जी, श्री सचिन जी, सभागार में उपस्थित विद्वज्जनों, समाज के विभिन्न क्षेत्रों के दिग्गजों, समाज के प्रति अपने कर्तव्य निभाने वाले सभी समाज प्रेमी बंधु भगिनी, इस कॉन्क्लेव के लिए विशेष रूप से प्रतिनिधि के रूप में आए हमारे नौजवान मित्रों, बहनों और भाइयों, मैं कहां से प्रारंभ करूं मैं सोच रहा था। द आउटसेट आई वुड लाइक टू प्लेस ऑन रिकॉर्ड माय हार्टफेल्ट थैंक्स टू ऑल ऑफ यू for congratulating me on this day, because it is something special in my life. But however, it got publicized and many have been wishing me today since morning, and here also you have done it. That's why, although it is not my great achievement, so everybody passes through this, and most of us may be celebrating also. I only consider that instead of adding years to life, try to add life to years. So that is why I choose to be in the midst of people like you, so that I can add life to my years. मित्रों, मुझे यहाँ इंटेलेक्चुअल, विद्वान वगैरह वगैरह कई शब्दों से जब परिचय आप कराते हैं, मुझे संकोच होता है, क्योंकि लोग मेरे बारे में झूठ नहीं बोलना चाहिए ऐसे। चंदन के बीच रहने वाली लकड़ी कुछ खुशबू पा लेती है, सुगंधित पुष्पों के बीच रहने वाले कागज के फूल भी कुछ सुगंध प्राप्त कर लेते हैं। तो मैंने कुछ यदि कहा है कुछ है तो ऐसे कार्यक्रम में वो बहुत सारे ऐसे विद्वानों से, लेखकों से, विचारकों से मैंने सुना है, उसी को मैं मेरे शब्दों में कहता हूँ, तो इससे अतिरिक्त नहीं है। विवेकानंद जी के प्रेरणा को लेकर प्रबुद्ध भारत, दिस हैज बीन एक्टिव इन बेलगाम फॉर लास्ट सेवरल इयर्स, एंड पर्टिकुलरली in last couple of years, Prabuddha Bharat, as they call themselves, an intellectual exercise, intellectual social responsibility. We all have heard about corporate social responsibility. CSR is a very much talked about concept today. So this intellectual social responsibility, some time back I mentioned about it, and Prabuddha Bharat has made it its byline. So one thing is whether there should be a social responsibility. If one has taken birth in any society or in any country, it is his bounden duty to give back something to his or her मदरलैंड, देश हमें देता है सब कुछ, हम भी तो कुछ देना सीखें। वन ऑफ द ग्रेटेस्ट प्रेसिडेंट्स ऑफ अमेरिका यूएस जॉन फिट्ज़गेराल्ड कैनेडी वंस सेड, आस्क नॉट व्हाट द कंट्री हैज गिवन टू यू, आस्क व्हाट यू हैव गिवन टू द कंट्री। सो दैट इज सोशल रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी। सो देन पेट्रियाटिज्म एंड सोशल रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी, वाई देर आर टू डिफरेंट टर्म्स। Social responsibility is to mold one's own personality to live for the society. It is not only sacrificing at a particular moment in a nation's life, maybe for its liberation from the foreign yoke, maybe at the time of war, maybe at the time of some natural calamities. The patriotic feeling has to be there originally, but the social responsibility is not only to die for the country, but to live for the country. If one has to live for the country, for the community, for the nation, for a greater cause, for a noble purpose, then one has to mold one's own life for that. So the thing is, intellectual is a very, I don't say bad word, but very tricky word. Who is an intellectual? It's very difficult to define. Anybody can claim that he's an intellectual, and anybody can introduce the other also as an intellectual, whatever may be the feeling in him, while introducing the other person as an intellectual. Whether he is doing it with the positive sense or the negative sense, we don't know. But many people claim intellectuals, and many people in this country have been claiming that they are eminent people, eminent historians. So it has become a business. So I call you eminent, you quote me as eminent in some other seminar, and then I quote you as eminent in some of my articles. So you scratch my back and I scratch your back, so that everybody becomes eminent and intellectuals. So this has been going on for the last several decades in this country, and that is why the people, ordinary people, have understood that these people, because of their positions and because of their celebrity status, because of their limelight in the media, so the country has more intellectuals today than politicians. So that's why when Prabuddha Bharat says that we want to give back to the society this intellectual social responsibility. Intellectual अपने देश में इंटेलेक्चुअल की सोशल रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी क्या है? उसके अंदर की एक बौद्धिक प्रामाणिकता चाहिए। इंटेलेक्चुअल ऑनेस्टी। ए रियल इंटेलेक्चुअल इज वन हु डज नॉट बिलोंग टू एनी पर्टिकुलर सेट ऑफ आइडियोलॉजी, बिकॉज आइडियोलॉजी इज अ क्लोज्ड माइंड। तो इसलिए बुद्धिजीवी बुद्धिधर्मी यह एक संत बनने के दिशा की प्रक्रिया है। इट इज अ प्रोसेस इन बिकमिंग अटेनिंग ए सेंटली नेचर। वे काश को भी मैं अंधेरा कहता हूं, मैं उस ट्रूथ को भी कंडेम करता हूं, ऑल दो आई नो दैट इट इज ट्रूथ। वो करना संत की मनस्थिति नहीं होती। तो इसलिए रियल इंटेलेक्चुअल अटेन्स द हायर पेडेस्टल ऑफ ए साइंटहुड, because it is an everlasting quest for truth. There is an intellectual honesty is required. In order to perform the social responsibility, the intellectuals will have to have this intellect, practice this intellectual honesty. Second, that is the personal character. बहुत बार पिछले कुछ दशकों में अनफॉर्चुनेटली वी हैव एक्सपीरियंस्ड दैट द इंटेलेक्चुअलिज्म इज मार्केट्ड इट कैन बी सोल्ड यू कैन गेट समथिंग पावर पोजिशन वेल्थ इन एक्सचेंज ऑफ माई इंटेलेक्चुअलिज्म देन द शार्पनेस द ट्रांसपेरेंसी The honesty, they get dimmed and diminished. They get blunted. तो intellectual honesty के साथ साथ वो जीवन के चरित्र नहीं है एक प्रामाणिकता से जीवन जीने के सत्य को सत्य स्वीकार करना एक है सत्य को सत्य कहने के जो हिम्मत चाहिए कम वॉट में मैं सत्य को सत्य है या असत्य को असत्य है यह कहने के हिम्मत रखना चाहिए फियरलेसनेस एंड दैट फियरलेसनेस इज द प्रोडक्ट ऑफ एन ऑनेस्ट लाइफ ऑफ ए ट्रांसपेरेंट लाइफ ए लाइफ ऑफ इंटेग्रिटी A life of sterling character. इसलिए राजाओं के दरबार में अपने विद्वत्ता को बुद्धिमत्ता को गिरवी रखने वाले लोग इंटेलेक्चुअल नहीं होते बहुत पुरानी एक कहानी है अपने देश की एक राजा के राज्य में देयर इज अ ग्रेट स्कॉलर बट ही वॉज लिविंग ए लाइफ ऑफ पेन्यूरी एक्सट्रीम पॉवर्टी ही कैन नॉट थिंक ऑफ द नेक्स्ट मील बट ही वॉज अ ग्रेट स्कॉलर ही प्रोड्यूस्ड मेनी थिंग्स बिकॉज ऑफ हिज फैंटास्टिक इंटेलेक्ट And people were praising about him, but ultimately the word went around that this great scholar is living such a hopeless life, suffering in such misery of poverty. When the king heard about it, he felt sorry and he said, "How can it happen in my state? So that in his kingdom it cannot happen." So he himself went to the door of that scholar, a small hut. तो उसने बहुत सारी चीजें लेके आए थे और राजा को राजा ने उनको नतमस्तक होकर उस विद्वान के सामने उनके चरण स्पर्श किया एंड ही ऑफर्ड ऑल दोज थिंग्स व्हाट ही हैड ब्रॉट गिव्स मनी एवरीथिंग I don't want all these things. There is no need for me. I want to earn my life, my livelihood, and I will live. I don't want your gracious grants like this. And I, no. You are a great scholar. You are living in such poverty. I cannot tolerate this. You are living such a life. So that it gives me pain. I am hurt. So that's why you please accept it. Then that scholar, वो great विद्वान अपने पत्नी को कहता है चलो भाई अपने पास जो जो है सब बांध लो हम इस राज्य को छोड़कर चले जाएंगे हम यहां रहकर अपने राजा को क्यों दुख दें I don't want to give you pain. सो आई विल गो अवे। मैंने कहा नहीं नहीं मेरी क्षमा कीजिए। मैंने कहा ये पहले ले जाओ तब मैं सुखी रहूंगा। एंड द किंग हैड टू टेक ऑल दोज थिंग्स बैक इन ऑर्डर टू सी दैट एटलीस्ट द स्कॉलर रिमेन्स इन हिज किंगडम। द इंटेलेक्चुअलिज्म ऑफ दिस ऑर्डर हैज टू बी रिक्लेम्ड टुडे इन इंडिया। जनार्दन ठाकुर बहुत बड़े एक पत्रकार थे अपने देश में। उन्होंने एक बार कहा था हमारे देश में क्या हो गया है, द एजुकेटेड इंटेलिजेंसिया एंड द पीपल हु कॉल देमसेल्व्स और द पीपल रिकॉग्नाइज देम एज इंटेलेक्चुअल्स दे हैव ए वेरी स्ट्रेंज माइंडसेट। And what is it? And Janardan Thakur, the eminent journalist of those days, he said in such words, following words. He said, the intellectuals of our country, they want to enjoy the facilities of the right and the image of the left. तो उनको वामपंथी बनने के जो इमेज है वो चाहिए, लेकिन जिनको वो गाली देते हैं ऐसे दक्षिणपंथी लोगों के सुख सुविधा भी चाहिए। तो दैट इज व्हाई जनार्दन ठाकुर सेड दे वांट टू एंजॉय द राइट एंड वांट टू हैव द इमेज ऑफ द लेफ्ट। यह प्रामाणिकता नहीं है। तीसरी बात यह है कि इंटेलेक्चुअल्स के साथ वो है क्रियात्मकता। भारत में हमने कहा यह क्रियावान स पंडित, पांडित्य जो है, विद्वत्ता जो है, स्कॉलरशिप, इट कैनॉट फ्लरिश ओनली बिकॉज समबडी इज सिटिंग इन द आइवरी टावर एंड थिंग्स एंड ड्रीम्स अबाउट द होल वर्ल्ड एंड यूनिवर्स एंड ही वॉन्ट्स टू प्रीच समथिंग टू द पीपल एंड डज नथिंग इन हिज लाइफ। यह क्रियामान स पंडित, ए स्कॉलर हैज टू बी एन एक्टिविस्ट। दैट्स व्हाई द इंटेलेक्चुअल एक्टिविज्म, intellectual activism in order to see that people of my country, my fellow beings, their life, it gets elevated. Rising the level of people, their consciousness is my responsibility, not only through my preachings and writings, but also I have to be active. क्रियात्मकता एंड द ग्रेट हेरिटेज ऑफ इंडियन इंटेलेक्चुअल्स, दे प्रैक्टिस्ड ऑल दीज थिंग्स इन देयर लाइफ। सो एट द बिगिनिंग आई वुड लाइक टू अंडरलाइन दैट प्रबुद्ध भारत विच हैज बीन वर्किंग फॉर द टू अचीव दिस great concept of intellectual social responsibility. So this has to be today underlined, this has to be regained, because that intellectual heritage of this land has been one of the guiding stars for the people all over the world. Mitro, the reclaiming the rightful dignity क्या है? आयोजकों ने क्या सोचा था, थोड़ा बहुत मैंने उनसे बात की। तो डिग्निटी ऑफ भारत, भारत की एक श्रेष्ठता है, भारत की एक प्रतिष्ठा, ए कवर्टेबल प्लेस इन द कमिटी ऑफ नेशंस विच भारत एंजॉयड for decades and centuries, not because of its military power, because as we all know, Bharat has never invaded any country, Bharat has never subjugated any part of the world, Bharat has never made anybody slaves in any part of this globe. So that has been the the very personality of India, even in her greatest days. सोने की चिड़िया होने वाली भारत दुनिया को शोषण नहीं किया, पराक्रमी लोगों की वीरताओं के प्रकट करने वाले लोगों की मालिका रखने वाले भारत ने दुनिया पर साम्राज्य करने के लिए किसी नेपोलियन को, किसी हिटलर को, किसी अलेक्जेंडर को यहां से नहीं भेजा। भारत ने भेजा संस्कृति प्रचारकों को, द कल्चरल डिप्लोमैट्स, द एम्बेसडर्स, द टीचर्स, इवन द किंग्स हु वेंट लाइक बोधिधर्मा फ्रॉम द साउथ इंडिया हु बिलोंग टू द रॉयल फैमिली हु बिकेम ए साइंट हु वेंट टू चाइना एंड टुडे थाउजेंड्स एंड थाउजेंड्स ऑफ चाइनीज families and homes, they have the image or the picture of Bodhidharma who taught them what life is and what life is for. There is a Hu Shi who was an ambassador of China to America. I think he was a professor also for some years, if I am right. And he told once that India had ruled China for nearly two centuries, for nearly 20 centuries, not sending even a single soldier, without sending even a single soldier, without killing even a single person, without using even a single weapon. India ruled China for nearly 20 centuries. This is what the ambassador of China, Hu Shi, he once said. How it was happened? Because of the various cultural, spiritual, religious aspects were taught to the people of China by the saints, monks, sages, scholars and teachers who traveled crossing Himalayas to China. So this is the heritage that we have. That is when Prabuddha Bharat says that we have to regain or reclaim the dignity of Bharat, which is rightful. So now the thing is, it's not only the revivalism that we visualize. That the olden days were always gold, so that is why we have to bring this. This revivalism is not the see, no nation can live only on the great memories of the past. A nation has to experience its present, analyze it, accept the challenges, and build brighter days for the future. That's what Swami Vivekananda, who is the inspiration for Prabuddha Bharat, has exhorted people. That we have to build a nation which is far, far more brighter than the past. That they don't live only in the past. That is a daydream of no substance or no use. So that's why when we remember the past, when we say that it should be, we have to reclaim a dignity because it was just once present, which was once guiding the whole humanity, which is still there. वो अपने देश में है कि नहीं? भारत के सामान्य लोगों के विजडम विचित्र है। अपने देश में सामान्य लोगों के विवेक, उनके जीवन के प्रति उत्साह, जीवन के प्रति प्रेम, यह किसी विद्यालय में विश्वविद्यालय में पढ़ने के कारण नहीं आया उनको. पीपल नो व्हाट दे वांट. इट इज ओनली दैट यू हैव टू प्रोवाइड द ऑर्डिनरी पीपल सर्टन बेसिक एम्यूनिटीज दैट सो दैट दे कैन लिव एंड एक्सपेरिमेंट विथ लाइफ. जैसे कुछ समय पहले हमारे एक देश के वन इंपॉर्टेंट वेरी प्रोमिनेंट इकोनॉमिस्ट वन सेड द फार्मर्स ऑफ इंडिया दे डू नॉट वॉन्ट मेनी मोर थिंग्स फ्रॉम द गवर्नमेंट. दे वॉन्ट एटलीस्ट water should be available for them. That's why in order to get the water, they want to run the engine so that they need some electricity in today's situation. You provide them enough water and all other things they will give. They will give you back gold. But instead of providing the basic things, we are binding them in many, very many things. That's why the problem starts. This is what that economist once said. So thing is, our people have the experience of this great civilization which is running through our blood veins. अपने देश के लोगों में यह एक अद्भुत चीज है. अमेरिका में स्पेल भी होती, स्पेलिंग भी. It's a competition about the English spellings. Recently also, one young boy, he became the first in spelling. It is some 27-letter word. And first, second, third places are generally won by the Indian origin students in America in spelling. It is not their mother tongue. But why Indian students are able to do that? One of the answers that is provided to this question is that the Indians have a very rare and strange ability to remember things. Memory. अपने देश में वेद को हजारों साल हम याद करके रखें. This oral tradition, and it in its a very very pristine form. जैसे पहले कहा होगा उसी प्रकार. उसके लिए एक पद्धति की है. A system was worked out, and generation after generation, this was taught to the next people, and it remained as part of our intellectual heritage today. A memory. तीन पीढ़ियों के नाम बताना चाहिए घर में. किसी कार्यक्रम होते हैं धार्मिक विधि, उसमें कहते हैं तुम्हारे बाप के, तुम्हारे दादा के, तुम्हारे परदादा के, सबका नाम बताओ. क्यों? ऐसे करते 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 मेमोरी हैज बिकम सच एन इंडिविजुअल पार्ट ऑफ एन इंडियन पर्सन. अपने देश में स्मरण शक्ति एक ऐसी चीज के नाते हमने उसको रिकॉग्नाइज भी किया, उसके लिए प्रैक्टिस भी की. इसलिए सामान्य सब्जी बेचने वाली महिला सड़क पर जो बैठती है फुटपाथ पर, उसके पास कोई कैलकुलेटर की जरूरत नहीं है. वो आप बताएंगे, आप कितने भी करिए, वो आप पैसे देंगे, वो कैलकुलेट करके वापस देती है. शी इज अनलेटर्ड वुमन, नॉट होल्डिंग ए कैलकुलेटर. How is it possible? Because this country has practiced a system of a kind that ordinary people are able to calculate, are able to remember, are able to memorize. यह जो हमारे ancestral property है वो हमें काम में आता है. Connecting with anybody. The Indian people who have gone anywhere in this world, they have invariably mingled with the local community, society. They have not picked up a quarrel. They have not flouted the local rules. They have been contributors in the building of the nation in those countries. They have become part and parcel of the society. But they are practicing their original Bharatiyata at home. This is a unique thing that has happened. With all the diversity, India lives as one nation today. What is that underlying factor that makes India as one nation? What is that silken bond that binds us? Which Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru mentioned as silken bond. Which Sir Vincent Smith, one of the greatest historians, who once said, with all the apparent diversities, India remains one nation. There must be some unique factor for this. That cultural oneness is there. Today that is being attacked. Today that is being destroyed. Because of certain vested interests. Because of certain political purposes. Unfortunately, sometime because of the invasion of the modern technology. The colonization in this country has made us mental slaves. Decolonizing the minds is the very important aspect of reclaiming the rightful dignity for Bharat. When I say colonization, we all know that more than 150 years we were ruled by the Europeans and particularly the British and in some other parts other Europeans. We have not come out of the dominance that has been there. हमें ऐसे ऐसे कार्यक्रमों में इंग्लिश में बात करनी पड़ती है. पांच भाषाओं के लोग हिंदुस्तान में एकत्र आते हैं तो कौन सी भाषा बोले? अच्छा है, चलो हमें जिन्होंने गुलाम बनाया उनकी भाषाएं बोलो. क्यों? क्योंकि मैं कन्नड़ में बोलूंगा तो बेलगाम में समस्या है, मराठी में बोलूंगा तो और ज्यादा समस्या है. चलो अपने देश की भाषा है इसलिए मैं संस्कृत में बोलूं तो समझ में नहीं आता. इसलिए क्या करें, इसलिए अच्छा है भाई इंग्लिश बोलो. 2% लोग गलत इंग्लिश हिंदुस्तान में बोलते हैं तो फिर भी हम इंग्लिश में बोलने की इच्छा रखते हैं. करें क्या? आई एम नॉट अगेंस्ट इंग्लिश लैंग्वेज. आई हैव बीन ए स्टूडेंट ऑफ इंग्लिश लिटरेचर एंड आई लव दैट लैंग्वेज. आई रेस्पेक्ट दैट लैंग्वेज बिकॉज दे हैव प्रोड्यूस्ड सम ऑफ द ग्रेटेस्ट लिटरेचर इन दिस वर्ल्ड. बट द फैक्ट इज हम अपने देश के भाषा को, इस डाइवर्सिटी को, अपने देश के इतने इस समृद्धि को हम आनंद से सेलिब्रेट करने की स्थिति के बजाय लड़ने की स्थिति क्यों करते? कॉलोनाइजेशन ऑफ माइंड. तो इसलिए डीकोलोनाइज करना यह आवश्यक हो गया. इस गुलामी से, इस मानसिक गुलामी से, बौद्धिक गुलामी से अपने को बाहर लाना पड़ेगा. देखिए दो बातें हैं. एक ऑपरेशन है अंग्रेजी में कहते हैं, जिसी के ऊपर ज्यादती करके, दमन करके उनको दबा के रखा, वो मजबूरी हो गई. मैं विरोध करता हूं लेकिन मेरे पास शक्ति नहीं है. बिकॉज आई एम वीक,
the oppressor, the foreign ruler, oppresses me and I became a slave. That is because of my weakness. Although I protest, I can't win. That is one stage. But colonization is another. That I but press the button, accept. मैं उनको स्वीकार करता हूं, आप श्रेष्ठ हैं. हिंदुस्तान में मुगलों के साम्राज्य रहा, यहां वो राज किए. भारतीय लोगों ने मुगलों के और उन आक्रांताओं के सामने झुके नहीं है. उन्होंने कभी नहीं सोचा ये सिविलाइजेशनली दे आर बेटर, कल्चरली दे आर सुपीरियर. Indians never thought about the Mughal invaders in these terms. Physically, they might have become weak. They struggled, they battled, they put up fights, they were killed, but they never accepted that the invader is superior to me insofar as cultural and civilizational aspects are concerned. But come the British rule, the white man's culture and civilization became superior in our minds. Humko lagna shuru ho gaya, ye humse better hai. We started licking the shoes of the foreigners. डिग्निटी उनके जूतों के नीचे कुचल दी गई. उस डिग्निटी को आज भी हम अपने सिर में जो गए हैं ना, उससे बाहर लाने के जो प्रयास है वो है राइटफुल डिग्निटी को रिक्लेम करना. तो इसलिए इस डीकोलोनाइजेशन का करते समय अपने देश के सांस्कृतिक एकता एकात्मता के जो बातें मैंने थोड़ा सा उल्लेख किया बीच में, भारत एक है, इसके नीचे के जो तत्व है हाउ अदर्स अंडरस्टैंड इट. आई पासिंगली रेफर टू सर विंसेंट स्मिथ, बट आई शुड नाउ रेफर टू अनदर इंसिडेंट विच मार्गरेट थैचर द फॉर्मर प्राइम मिनिस्टर ऑफ Britain, once discussing with Kuldeep Nayarji, who was the High Commissioner to UK, Indian High Commissioner. Those were the days when the USSR was collapsing. Mikhail Gorbachev was the leader. He was heading the USSR. And there were internal contradictions. And every day he was feeling that USSR cannot remain one united state. It's crumbling, collapsing. Already the Baltic states had broken away. And dismemberment was immense. And he was feeling the writing on the wall was there. And during those days there was an international conference or some summit, which was also attended by Margaret Thatcher, the Prime Minister of those days. And when she came back to London, she had some informal get together, and in one of the such informal tea, Kuldeep Nair, the governor, the High Commissioner, he asked her, how was your Russian trip? The madam said, it was good. How is Russia today? What Gorbachev feels? No, he is unable to keep the country united. Why it's happening? Because a lot of diversities. United Soviet, USSR was an artificial conglomeration, as we all know. Today there is no USSR. There is only Russia. And other parts have already dismembered and they have gone away. And those were the days when it was on the threshold of dismemberment. And she said, Gorbachev is at pains. He is feeling that he cannot keep the such a diverse situation united. Then Kuldeep ji asked Mrs. Thatcher, what is your suggestion? What is your advice? Margaret Thatcher told, I told him, why don't you take advice from your long-term friend, long-time friend? What do you mean? I said, why don't you consult India? Kuldeep Nair asked, why? Why did you suggest this way? Margaret, do you know? India with all such diversities of every kind in the world, caste, community, language, richness, poorness, poverty, that, climatic, food, hundreds of varieties and diversities that we can see all over the world is present in your country. And still, from north to south and east to west, you remain one nation, which is supreme. Margaret Thatcher recognized this cultural unity of India, and she suggests to another head of the state so that he can consult his long-time friend, India. What Gorbachev did, I don't know. Friends, this conclave is having four aspects of reclaiming dignity: sociological, technological, educational, and political. Step. Very eminent speakers and thinkers and thought leaders are going to present their views and have their exchange thoughts with you in the coming sessions. As some of the earlier speakers have told that there is going to be an intellectual feast. I do agree. So mera kaam kya hai? Koi bhi feast mein, kisi bhi prakar ke aap swadisht cheezon ko lenge, usmein thoda sa to namak to chahiye, tabhi to swadisht hoga. Without salt, there is no taste. I am putting some salt. Because the next sessions will be tastier. Already they are tasty, and they will going to be tastier. The taste that I want to add through the salt is the Bharatiyata is the thing without which a technological, educational, political, sociological aspects and endeavors in this country are meaningless. They are tasteless. Economic. Many a time people think that Indian philosophy and Indian cultural thing, they do not consider this mundane worldly life to be a happy, very grand, rich one. Always the Indian philosophy means they think about the supramundane thing, the otherworldly thing, the spiritual world. Is it so? 5,000 plus years civilization has talked of 64 kalas. 64 kala hai. Duniya mein aur kisi civilization mein nahi bola. Humne yahan samutkarsh aur nichres, abhyudaya aur nichres ki baat ki. Jina chahiye. Live life to the brim. But live without attachment. Ye aapka nahi hai. Lekin aapko isko jine ka adhikar hai. Aise, jaise Gandhi ji ne kaha, like a trustee. Aapko yahan jine ka adhikar hai. Har cheez ko upyog karne ke bhi aap kar sakte ho. But the thing is, with dharmic values. Aapko yahan jina chahiye. Kaise? Tadiyogastu Govinda Tubhyameva Samarpaye. This is your creation. It belongs to you. I use it only for my bare needs. But we should live. इसलिए भारत में अर्थ और काम इसके बारे में घृणा नहीं थी. They were not desisted. They were not discarded. They were not demeaned. But sublime them. Ennoble them. अर्थ और काम को धर्म के साधन के रूप में, धर्म को अचीव करने के दृष्टि से अर्थ और काम का उपयोग होना चाहिए. अर्थ के बारे में हमने ऐसे सोचा. ऑर्डिनरी कपल, उन्होंने पति और पत्नी साधना करने के लिए निकले. जीवन में सब कुछ हो गया भाई, बाकी चीज छोड़ो, अभी जीवन के कुछ अच्छे चीजों के बारे में जाएं, इन्हीं चीजों के, अपने ही घर, अपने ही चीजें, अपने संपत्ति, ये वो, अपनी प्रतिष्ठा, अपने स्थान, इन्हीं बातों के बारे में हम, अब सब छोड़ो, चलो ये दुनिया और क्या है, सब कुछ नहीं, तो क्या करें, साधना करें. तो इसलिए दोनों चले, सब कुछ छोड़कर चले. तो रास्ते में जाते समय सड़क पर कहीं सम गोल्ड रिंग वॉज देयर और सम ऑर्नमेंट, किसी ने छोड़ दिया था, कैसे गिर गया था, तो तुरंत पति के आंखों में आ गया. ही सॉ इट एंड ही फेल्ट द लेडी विल बी अननेसेसरली टेम्प्टेड, क्योंकि गोल्ड देखते हैं तो उनको, पुरुषों को यही लगता है मुझसे साधना में थोड़ा महिला कम है, ऐसा उसको लगा. तो इसलिए उनको लगा उसको मिट्टी से कवर करें, तो इसलिए थोड़ा मिट्टी गोद कर उसको डालकर रखने, थोड़ा चार कदम सामने थी. एंड शी टर्न्ड बैक एंड सेड, व्हाट आर यू डूइंग? नहीं नहीं कुछ नहीं कर रहा हूँ. तो आ गई. देन द शाइनिंग गोल्ड ऑर्नमेंट वॉज जस्ट, शी लुक्ड एट इट. तो उन्होंने कहा नहीं नहीं ऐसे है, तो झूठ नहीं बोला पत्नी के साथ, उन दिनों की कहानी है, आज की नहीं है. तो इसलिए उसने कहा कि तो नहीं नहीं वो सोने के कुछ है ना, इसलिए तुम्हारे मन में आशा ना आए, इसलिए मैं मिट्टी से. तो उनको लगा उसको ही चंचल मन रहता है, इसलिए पुरुष को लगा. लेकिन महिला ने कहा अरे मिट्टी पर मिट्टी क्यों डाल रहे हो भैया? अर्थ के प्रति दृष्टि, जीवन जीने तक जिए, लेकिन वो अपने ऊपर न सवार करे. वेल्थ इज रिक्वायर्ड फॉर लाइफ, बट आई शुड नॉट बिकम ए स्लेव टू वेल्थ. दिस हैज बीन द अप्रोच टू वेल्थ इन आवर कंट्री. बट यू हैव टू बिल्ड, वी हैव बिल्ट ग्रेट मैंशंस. 64 कलाएं मैंने जो बताया, 64 कलाएं का आप देखिए सूची. अर्थ और काम के बारे में हमारे यहां का भगवत गीता में भगवान कृष्ण कहते धर्मा विरुद्धो कामोस्मि भूतेषु भरतर्षभ. प्राणियों में, सब जीवियों में धर्म के विरुद्ध जो नहीं है वह काम मैं हूं, भगवान कृष्ण कहते धर्मा विरुद्धो कामोस्मि भूतेषु भरतर्षभ. हमने काम कामनाओं को, वासनाओं को ऐशना के रूप में रखा, लेकिन भारत के लोगों ने उसके गुलाम नहीं बनना, उससे ऊपर कैसे बने, अर्थ और काम को सब्लाइम पर कैसे ले जाएं. इसलिए द इकोनॉमिक अप्रोच, द अप्रोच टू लाइफ, द अप्रोच टू हैप्पीनेस, अप्रोच टू वर्ल्डली थिंग्स, दे हैव टू बी मेड इनटू ब्यूटिफुल आर्ट, दे आर यूजफुल फॉर द वर्ल्ड. They have to be the instruments to bring life to a higher level. But at the same time, we should also know their limitations. We should also know what role they can play and what role they shouldn't play. The strength and the weakness of artha and kama should be understood. They have great strength, but also they have great weaknesses. This has to be taught, and the education is for that. अपने देश की शिक्षा पद्धति ऐसे रही. भारत में शिक्षा पद्धति नहीं थी, ऐसे नहीं है. ब्यूटीफुल ट्री पुस्तक में धर्मपाल जी हैज वंडरफुली ब्रॉट आउट द सिस्टम दैट वाज देयर टिल द एडवेंट ऑफ द यूरोपियंस इन दिस कंट्री. 1757 द प्लॉसी वॉर, 1760 तक जो एजुकेशन सिस्टम, and that has been recorded with the British records, with statistics, with facts and figures. I do not say that that education system should prevail only today. For the modern times, we have to definitely, certainly, unquestionably, we will have to build upon that. The modern times, the needs of the modern times may be different, but the purpose of education cannot be different. Today's our students will have to embrace the whole world. The international quality of our education, the global quality of our education should be ascertained, no doubt about it. If you have produced Nalanda, Takshashila, Vikramshila, etc. in those days, we should not harp upon only those olden days. Why not we build a Harvard? Why not we build a Stanford? Why not we build an Oxford? Why not we have a Cambridge? Why not? But again, without the basic essence of Bharatiyata, those great education institutions cannot cater to the needs of the world because they lack Bharatiyata and only pick up some skills and some tricks and some other subjects from different corners of the world, and you make your institution great. It's not going to be great. What is there, the greatness of your country in that? That has to be reclaimed. The research in education for the today's has to be on one side, how we will be building a education system with structure, with atmosphere, and the content, and the policy, and the administrative needs, and the funding. All these things will have to be worked out for the modern days, for the next 25 years, no doubt. Because we have to provide education for the people who are lacking, not only in this country, anywhere in the world. Because providing teachers is the responsibility of Bharat for the whole world. We have to provide. Why not? If you can provide nurses, if you can provide IT software personnels, if you can provide doctors, can't we provide good teachers? We should provide. We should export teachers for all corners of the world. Our teachers should become the teachers of the modern next generation of every part of the world. And those teachers will not be teaching only the books, but they will be teaching, as just now Professor Karisiddhappa told about the life skills, how to behave. Education is a manifestation of perfection which is already in man. What is that perfection? And how it can be manifested? It has to be taught, not through because of some smart classes, but because of the integrity of the teacher, because of the personal behavior and life of the teacher. And that such great teachers, like in any other technological, medical fields, our youngsters can become models and examples for the world. Teachers also should become the examples for the whole world. We have to reclaim it, because Vishwaguru Bharat ko banna hai, वो रिक्लेम करना है तो हम गुरुओं को यहां से एक्सपोर्ट करना पड़ेगा. टेक्नोलॉजी साइंस, कुछ लोग कहते थे भारत में साइंस एंड टेक्नोलॉजी की हेरिटेज है ही नहीं. Two decades back, I attended a program in Indians of Science in Bangalore. One Dr. Kovur, he delivered a talk for more than an hour. The title of the talk was, "There is no scientific heritage in India." With all his pains, he tried to prove that how India lived in dark ages, how we did not know anything, and there was no scientific heritage. Intellectual dishonesty. Not only ignorance. He knew, but he wanted to prove a different thing. But the audience were not fools. Half a dozen people started asking questions and quoting from various. What I want to say is, India had a great scientific heritage. In every department of life, whether it is textile, medicine, agriculture, town planning, shipbuilding, war weaponry, we have achieved. But the science is not a closed book. Civilization is not a dead end at some point of time, everything is over. It is an ongoing process. So that is why today's our youngsters, the modern day scientific advancements elsewhere in the world will have to be understood in its proper perspective. And that science is also for the greater ennobling dharmic values. That is why nowadays we feel, we hear the term technology with human face. Technology with human face means what? Pandit Deen Dayal Upadhyay once said, what type of technology you want? It has to create, no doubt, better life, jobs, make our life more meaningful and happy. That's why he said simple. Economy, ecology, and ethics. They should be the guiding principles for the technological advancement. A technology should not mar my economy. Means it should not destroy the jobs, but it has to create more jobs so that the hands and minds of the people are utilized for the best. Economy has to be taken care of. Ecology has to be taken care of. Ethical order, ethics, that has to be kept in mind. With these three major guiding principles, technological advancement has to take place. The Indian talent is capable enough of producing such a technological atmosphere and environment for Bharat and for humanity. So friends, in very many ways, the reclaiming of India's dignity is not for India alone. Because India doesn't live for herself. India lives for the entire humanity. That is why her dignity is accepted and prized. If India had lived only for India, it is another selfish exercise. India lives for the world. In order to do this, to reclaim the dignity, I will be taking one more minute extra. Already I have crossed time, I know. Sorry for that. The three tasks Maharishi Aurobindo has very clearly, he has underlined three tasks for, in today's topic, if I have to connect it, for the reclaiming of the rightful dignity of India. during the freedom struggle days, he was thinking about future India, and he said the first task, he says there are three tasks that India has to accomplish. I quote, "The first task is to recover the ancient spiritual knowledge in its fullness, in amplitude." When I say ancient Indian knowledge, I think I need not explain all those things. It is not only Veda, Upanishad, etc., they also, and the entire heritage of knowledge that we have in this country from different parts of this country at different times. The second task, Sri Aurobindo has said, India has to pour that knowledge into new modes of philosophical, scientific, and critical knowledge areas. It is not only to regain the old knowledge, but also to pour those knowledge into the areas of philosophical, scientific, and critical knowledge. This is a very difficult task. So that has to be done. And the third task Sri Aurobindo has mentioned is to deal with the contemporary problems in a new manner and to realize a spiritualized society. So the old knowledge has to be reclaimed. It is there, everywhere. One such effort is to collect the manuscripts. That is one effort. Scores of such efforts have to take place. Then again, to restate, to redefine, to pour that knowledge into every department of life so that we try to remold our lives in different aspects with Bharatiyata. But that is not the end. In order to see that we create a new modern India, we will have to create new knowledge also. Creation of new knowledge. And as he said, deal with the contemporary problems in a new manner, and ultimately to realize a spiritual society, spiritualized society. So this is how reclaiming of rightful dignity is possible. At the end, I would like to quote Jean-Pierre Lehmann, who was the director of the International Management Institute in Switzerland. He has spoken about the monotheism and polytheism. That is a long debate. I would not like to dwell into that. But he has written in his book, after studying Arabic, Chinese, European, and Soviet models, and makes a prediction for the future in which he mentions about his expectation from Bharat. What he says is this, I quote, "The global environment is desperate for ideas, philosophy, and religion. India is the most prolific birthplace of all three due to its demography, democracy, and diversity. The Indian religion, philosophy, and traditions provide the sense of moral order, spirituality, and an ethical compass, and the sense of right and wrong that is integral to it." This is what Lehmann says. And then he says, 21st century, better be inspired by India's polytheism in order to achieve these things. Then he questions, else what? Ye nahi kiya to kya hoga? He adds, else we are headed for a disaster. Friends, why we should reclaim the rightful dignity of Bharat is to achieve this, because we have to provide moral order, spirituality, and ethical compass to the humanity. In order to give somebody, you have to earn something. If there is nothing in the godown, don't keep it in the showroom. So that's why the first thing is to fill the godown and try to make a show and then provide to the world. I think Prabuddha Bharat is very rightfully contributing to this great process of reclaiming the rightful dignity. I congratulate them and I wish them all the best, and also wish this conclave a resounding success. Namaskar.